Glad to have everybody back together again. Sorry we missed last year, but we're glad to have all the partner sponsors as well that you can see listed here. Everybody's put a lot of work into making this thing work. We hope it has the right kind of content for you today. We'll hopefully get a survey out at the end like we do every year, so you can give some real feedback. Is this the kind of content you're looking for to help us become better, more capable senior finance leaders? So thank you again for being here and being a part of this. I have a couple of comments I want to make, speaking to the theme of this year's conference a little bit, and then we'll turn it over to the keynote. Okay, I wanted to share a couple of moments and a couple of observations I've had about becoming a transformational CFO. What is it, and how do you become a transformational CFO? And one of the first things I've observed is that there's a direct relationship between the maturity or size of an organization and the perception of what the CFO is and does and the value a CFO brings to an organization. So in other words, you know, smaller, earlier stage companies tend to look at a CFO as, that's the guy or gal that does my accounting. They're the ones that do my forecasting. And as an organization matures, they tend to start thinking of a CFO as a real strategic partner in the business. And that's not always true, but I've observed it to be fairly true in many cases. Now, that doesn't mean necessarily that in large companies, advanced companies, mature companies have the right perception of a CFO either. In fact, you know, there's this study that was done by Deloitte that shows they first asked CFOs, what are the activities you do that bring the most value to an organization? You can see those listed kind of top down. And our view is like we're providing a lot of value in some of these key areas, right? They're that lighter blue bar on top. The challenge is when our peers were asked, what do we do that brings value to the organization? They're that dark blue bar. And so you can see there's some clear gaps. The ones in green, those are the ones that we think we're providing more value than our peers think. And then opposite is true of the pink or however that shows up there. They think we're providing value in these areas. And the areas that they think we're providing more value are the traditional things. Forecasting, accounting, cost management. And so there's this clear perception gap of the value we bring versus what our peers think we bring. And that still exists out there. Now, why does that gap exist? Honestly, a lot of that is self-perpetuated, self-inflicted. If you doubt it, you can probably think back to the earliest story I can find of a CFO and his experience. Has been told. This story has been told over and over and over for generations, for thousands of years even. You may even remember this biblical story. The arrow's pointed at the CFO in the back. This has been painted. You remember this story, right? There's a certain ruler. He's got a VP of finance. He's got a VP of sales and a VP of marketing. He gives the marketing guy like $5 million, gives the sales guy $2 million, and the CFO gives $1 million and says, go grow this thing for me. Now, we all know the end of this story, right? The marketing guy, the sales guy, they go out and double the investment, come back, and they're given more responsibility, and everything's great. The CFO, afraid to spend, right? He's out there burying it in the back because he doesn't want to lose anybody. He wants to protect the assets, right? So we know the end of that story, right? He's fired. He goes off gnashing his teeth. It's kind of a strange painting, actually. If you look closely at his face, it's kind of crazy, actually. Now, the truth is, thankfully, the role of CFO has evolved, particularly in the last few years, to being one that's a little more focused on value creation. It's not just forecasting, it's not just accounting. There is an expectation that CFOs do more in a business. I've often said that the role of a CFO is to get your arms around all of the data in a business. Not just the financial data, but all the data in a business. And then present it back to the organization in a way that helps them make better decisions. I like this statement by Jonathan at Cisco. I think he was the VP of finance, not the CFO. But he said, finance, while it doesn't actually own the strategy, is responsible for offering a framework against which we can present our strategic choices of how we're going to develop as a company. Finance makes sure the right choices are framed up. One, that framework does need to include more than finance data for sure. But how does a CFO frame up the right decisions for an organization? That's the key to becoming a transformational CFO. And I want to suggest that there are three keys that our focus today is going to be much around some of these things. First of all, we want to create a framework for our organization to understand how is value created in this business. Every business is different. As long as we can help the leaders in an organization understand what are the value levers in our business, that's the first key. The second is investing in upscaling our finance teams and teaching them, turning them into value creation partners, and then launching them in the business to peddle your influence and to help people think a little bit differently about the business. And then finally, motivating your team, igniting them, giving what they need to go out and do just that and measure their impact in the business. I just want to touch on each of these three quickly. The first, this statement comes from a CFO of a private equity shop you can see there. He says, as a former CEO, I understand that one of the toughest things to deal with is getting people to tell you the truth. Everyone's career and compensation is affected by the CEO, and everyone has an incentive to tell the CEO what they want to hear. Sounds familiar, right? He goes on and says, a CFO's great relationship with their CEO means always telling the truth as they know it, providing your unvarnished opinion, and being the source of unbiased data to help drive every decision. In short, the CFO's responsibility is to use data in a framework that the organization understands to always tell the truth, to prevent the organization from relying on hyperbole and anecdotes to drive strategy. We need to show them the truth in data that fits into this value framework we've created. Second, investing in upscaling your team. AI, machine learning, these are going to be the very front of what we're going to be doing, delivering value as CFOs, for sure, in the next few years. There's a couple of really interesting quotes here. Mine are too small here. So I'm going to let you read a couple of these, see if I can. That we're augmenting our intelligence. And then finally, it says something about the new currency is no longer oil, it's data. Thanks. Another area to invest in upscaling our team, of course, is around automation of processes. This survey that was done by Deloitte as well shows that there's still an awful lot of work done, ready to be done in our organizations with respect to automation. 75% of companies, and these are larger companies, 75% of companies still have largely manual processes. And so as we focus on that, there's a ton of opportunity for us in the near term as well. Finally, igniting your team. This is where we need to encourage our team, once they've been trained, our finance team, our accounting team, once they've been trained on ROI thinking, how to teach people to think from an ROI perspective, then we push them out into the organization to improve the influence of what we're doing. This statement's a great one. One of the things that we like to talk a lot about here is creating financial literacy in the organization. This is at Pepsi. That sounds like a lofty term, but what it really means is making sure that when the sales guy goes into a store, he has the tools to understand what the right price points are, what the right package mix is, to have a real impact. We and our teams need to be out in the organization teaching people how to think like this. Only that is going to reduce this perception gap that exists out there. Only that's going to develop the respect for the office of CFO. Not for any reason that we just want respect, but the more respect we have, the more we're able to influence the organization for good. So as we do these three things, create value frameworks, as we upscale our team, and as we get them out of the organization doing so, much of which we're going to be focused on today in these breakouts, we'll be able to really become transformative CFOs and drive value in a business. So I hope you're able to learn some great things today. We appreciate your feedback, and we'll hopefully get some of that back at the end of the day in a Google survey you'll get later. But we're thankful you're here. I'm going to turn the time over to Wells, who's going to introduce our keynote speaker. Thank you.